Good morning, everybody. This is Zoology for October 8th. I'm Mr. Sheridan. I hope you're all having a great day. Let's jump right into it because we are starting a new unit. Now that we did our short quiz on rabbits and we've kind of wrapped up our rabbit section, and we're going to revisit rabbits again in the springtime when we're actually breeding our rabbits here at the facility so people can get more involved, and we'll actually have some days to come in and we'll review some of the stuff that we've done over the last couple of weeks about rabbit anatomy and digestion and reproduction. But now we're going to jump into a livestock unit and we're going to focus on reproduction and physiology. So really what we're doing and where we're going to start is that we're going to start with anatomy. And in exactly the same way that we did with the rabbits, we're going to identify the different parts of animals. So for our first unit today, I want everybody to jump into your Google Classroom. As always, please do your daily attendance and your daily check-in. Those don't take very long, just jump in and do them. And then you'll see under week 8, we've got all our stuff that we were working on before down here. But today, you'll see that there are 7 different labeling activities posted here. And what I want you to do is each person needs to focus on 2. You need to pick 2 of them. So we have a chicken. We have a dairy cow. We've got a doe. A gilt, a heifer, a horse, and a ewe. And for those of you who don't know all that terminology, we'll go through some of those as we go through. For instance, so when we talk about a dairy cow, in cattle, cows are females that have had calves. Heifers are females that have not had calves yet. The same goes for actually does or just does all the time. So we're going to have, does, whether they've had whether they've had kids or not are going to be called does. Gilts become sows when they have a litter. So right now, when we're talking about, female pigs that haven't had a litter yet, we call them gilts. So what I want you to do is I'm going to go through the heifer, anatomy really quick, and I'm going to show you what all of these are. But what I want you to do, your assignment for today, is you need to pick 2 of these. And these are listed as PDFs. You've all got a copy. You can download them in your into Notability, and you can write on these and you can use all these words, and I want you to come up with these labels. So we're going to roll through this one really quickly because we are going to focus on beef cattle more than any of the others, between beef and dairy cattle, because those are the resources that I have really great access to, as far as we're going to be able to actually go in and palpate some reproductive tracts if we can get some students in the building that are interested in that. So you're actually going to be able to see and get your hands on how those reproductive tracts work, how these animals are actually become pregnant, and how that process works. So we're going to focus on cattle a little bit, but what I really want you to do is I want you to pick a second one as well. So you're going to do beef cattle for sure, and then you're going to do another one. So if you chose beef cattle, and this is all going to go back to your safety exploration project that we did over the, that was our first summative. Whatever species you chose for that, we're going to use that facility that you all designed back then. We're going to use that as we go through the year. So pick that species. Some of you did goats, some of you did horses, some of you did beef cattle. If you did beef cattle, do this one and then pick another one just for fun. But what I want you to do is 2 of these, I want you to label them. So if we run through these, we can see, and what I will do is I have access to all the answer keys here. So if we go down here and we're just gonna pull up the heifer answer key really quickly, and we're gonna run through these. You're gonna notice that a lot of these are gonna be different. And because we're recording this, you can go back and you can pause the video if you click on the instructional link. So if you're struggling with one, you can go back through here. But as you can see, a lot of animals are gonna have a poll. Some of these identification names are gonna be different for some animals, and some of them are gonna be the same. We've got a muzzle and a dewlap, the point of their shoulder where that bone's gonna stick out toward the front of that heifer. the knee, and then their cannon bone. This whole cannon bone is like their forearm. We think of it as between our wrist and our elbow. Same sort of thing. Their cannon bone is right here. This pasterns, you'll notice that some of these lines aren't exactly all lined up because of this grass clip art they have down here. The pastern is really like their ankle. It's like this part down here. It's the part that's actually going to flex. We want them to have lots of flex to their pastern. That dew claw is actually the little bone, just like your dogs are going to have dew claws that are going to stick out up on their leg. We got a switch part of a tail, a hock, which is going to be similar. We did that in rabbits too. So your hock is right here, this big joint that is on their rear leg. Stifle is this entire muscle. This entire lower leg muscle is going to be their stifle. Obviously their udder is going to be between their rear legs. We call this back half, in some animals they're going to refer to it as the hindquarters. In cattle, we would just call it the quarter, is what we refer to as their rump, this whole hind end. If you think about it as the hindquarter, we're just going to call it the quarter. These hook and pin bones are very, very important. When we get into livestock judging, we'll talk that we're hoping that cattle are level from hooks to pins. You may have heard that term before. What that means is that this hook bone, which is right up here, which is kind of their hip bone that kind of sticks out a little bit, it's very prominent in dairy cattle. For those of you who have been around dairy cattle a little bit, that's called their hook bone. And then their pin bone is, you're going to have a pin bone on either side of their tail head right over here. So we're hoping that cattle, when their hip is made correctly, that they're level from hooks to pins. Their tail head is this whole object that's way up here. Then we've got our rump. Probably not going to use that term a ton, but we definitely want to talk about their loin and their rib and their fore rib. So when we're describing livestock, we're going to talk about their fore rib, their lower fore flank. This would be their rear flank. If you had that, you don't have to identify that. But talking about the top of their shoulder, and then we're going to talk about their top line is the term that we're going to use when we describe those things. So just a quick way to run through the dairy heifer version. I will pull up these other answer keys just very quickly so that if you want to pause this recording, you can, and if anybody is interested in the male parts of these, I put all the female diagrams up because we're going to have more females typically in a livestock facility than the males. But if you're interested in seeing the male parts and if they're at all different, then we can do that too. So here's our chicken answer key. I'm just going to pull up all these answer keys really quickly so that you can pause if you have to go back and fill these out. I want you to try to do them by yourself or go and find the answers. But if you need to go back through here, and you're going to notice in the dairy cow, there's going to be a ton of information about that cow's udder. Super duper important. The most important part of a dairy cow is how her udder is attached, how her udder sits. And we've got one of the young people in our class actually can probably do a better job of explaining that than I can. But since she's showing, in fact, she's at World Dairy Expo right now. But that if you talk, dairy judging is so different than other livestock judging because they have a scorecard and 40% of that animal is just based on their udder. So obviously it's super duper important that udder is good. So here's our doe. And let's see, we've got, here's our gilt. Our female swine diagram. So I'm just going to pause these just for a second so that you can see them and you can pause those if you need to. Here's our horse answer key. Ethan, you can probably do this one on your own. But that's what they're calling all of these body parts. And then the final one is a ewe or a lamb. So you're going to see, it's really interesting to me. There's a few terms that are very different. If we go back to the horse, they're going to call their chest or their, what we would call in livestock, in cattle, in sheep, in hogs, we call it their rib. We describe how wide or how capacious their rib is versus horses and actually goats, they call it the barrel. So a few different terms there, and that's what we're going to talk a lot more about as we get going through this subject. So Again, your assignment for today is to go into Google Classroom and find two of those livestock species that you are interested in and make sure you get them labeled correctly. If you have any questions at all, please shoot me an email. But otherwise, I hope you all have a wonderful day. I won't see you tomorrow unless I have you in advisory. But I hope you all have a great long weekend, and I will see you on Tuesday of next week. Have a great day.